I love thee because thou hast first loved me and purchased my pardon on Calvary's tree. I love thee for wearing the thorns on thy brow. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now.
Today we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the risen Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
You might notice behind me we're doing some construction. That's why you see a ladder there. It's not really the ladder to heaven. It just looks like it. Let us put ourselves before God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you come as light in the midst of darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come as healing in the midst of brokenness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come as wisdom in the midst of confusion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On Peter's arrival, Cornelius, a centurion of the Italian cohort, met him and, falling at his feet, worshiped him. But Peter made him get up, saying, "Stand up, I am only a man." Then Peter began to speak. "I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right, it is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles. For they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have? So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. Brothers and sisters, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Revealed to the nations his saving power, his saving power. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power, his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him. His holy arm. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power, his saving power. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power, his saving power. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power, his saving power.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. My sisters and brothers, word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
You're reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be your joy and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends. If you do what I command, I do not call you servants any longer, because a servant does not know what the master is doing, but I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commandments so that you may love one another. My brothers and sisters, our salvation, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite you to think back when you made your first communion. Now, for some of you all, that was a fair amount of time ago. For me, it was over 65 years ago. It was at St. Joseph's Parish in Spokane, Washington. I was in second grade. And I remember the nuns put the fear of God into us, that this is really, really important and special, and you better do it right. But they also put a sense of awe and wonder, like somehow when we had First Communion, there was probably like 40 kids in this class. It was, you know, but all of us had this sense of, wow, something really special is happening, and we better be ready for it, and we better not blow the opportunity. So I remember receiving communion, coming back and kneeling down. A sister said, when you come back, make sure you go and bow your head and go and thank God for the fact that Jesus showed up for everyone, all of us in the class. I'm sure a sister had a couple of thoughts about some of the kids in our class, but she would probably be surprised where I am today, but who knows. But I remember the sense of awe and just wonder. And this weekend we have 10 children making First Communion. And talking to a couple of the kids last Sunday, I said, well, next Sunday you're going to receive communion. One of the little kids says, I'm so excited. I'll get to have Jesus right inside me. And I can talk to him and tell him what I want to talk to him and thank him. And just the children's sense of openness and just that sense of pure excitement and joy, like, wow, this is coming. Well, for many of us who are the older Catholics who've been doing this for years and years and probably decades, it's often easy to take for granted the fact that when we come to communion to Mass, we get to receive not just a remembrance of Jesus, like, you know, the Baptist Church across the street has the first Sunday of the month has Communion Sunday, and that communion is a remembrance, but we get 100% real Jesus. We get the whole deal. And it's so easy for us to take that for granted. I mean, a second reading says that God is love. And so I think one of the greatest visible ways that God shows his love for us is through Jesus in the Eucharist, as we receive the bread and the wine, the body and blood of Jesus. It's such a tangible thing that we can literally take and eat, and Jesus becomes part of us. And if you are what you eat, then we get a chance to be a little bit like Jesus, hopefully, because of receiving Eucharist. You know, God is love is such an important phrase in the second reading, because oftentimes I think the reverse is true. Wherever love is, God sneaks in. I think God sneaks into lots of situations and relationships where people never give God credit for being there. But God's there anyway. Wherever love is present, God is present. And so we celebrate on Sunday these kids making First Communion that the families have loved them enough to first get them baptized, to bring them to church, to bring them to Sunday school week after week, to go over with them at home their prayers and what we believe as Catholics while we gather every Sunday. And so in a sense, they're going to receive from us, the older folks, what we receive from our parents and grandparents and probably a couple of nuns and priests along the way. So just think how many generations of shoulders we stand on, people of faith who've gone before us, who are now saints in God's kingdom. But because their belief that Jesus is really real and really present in the Eucharist is what we learned and what our faith is about. You know, the gospel Jesus talks about, he said, no longer are you servants, now you're friends. There's a whole different relationship. And the relationship we celebrate is that we have Jesus present with us every time we gather. And so maybe it's an opportunity for us older folks to celebrate the wonderful gift we have of Jesus in the Eucharist, and how that, you know, we can ask the Lord as he's inside of us to give us that grace and courage and wisdom and strength and compassion we need each day to carry on, and to keep passing on the faith to the next generation behind us, to our children and grandchildren and nieces and nephews and the people here in the community. And I mentioned specifically many of you who are watching and praying with us at home on our YouTube Mass, that if you have not had a chance to receive communion in a while, if you let us know, we often can work out a way that you can get communion. And I say to the folks who come to Mass and don't receive for some reason, if there's something that keeps you away from coming to communion, talk with me, talk to Deacon Bobby. Often there's easy ways to fix that. I mean, I remember talking to one person once and said, well, I don't see you come to communion. You know what? I just don't feel worthy. Worthy? I don't feel worthy. That's not a good excuse. And so I talked and said, hold it. This is not about us being worthy. It's about God being generous. It's all about what the scriptures say, that God loved us so much, he sent his own son Jesus to die for us and to be present with us and to stay with us every time we gather to celebrate his word, to celebrate the Eucharist at the table, and to celebrate the power of his spirit. So it's not about us being worthy. It's about us being grateful of how Jesus comes to us. So may we give God thanks and praise this weekend as we celebrate with our kids making First Communion. And remember the enthusiasm we probably had back in our First Communion in second or third grade, and celebrate and thank God for this wonderful gift of Jesus, 100% real Jesus, every time we gather for Mass. What a blessing, what a gift. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray our belief. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Let us present to the Lord our needs. For all those who have died, for Elizabeth Cofield, Alfred Percy, and Lois Blackwell, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of our children preparing for reception of First Communion this weekend, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace in the Middle East, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
I invite you to lift up your own needs and concerns. Lord God, we present you these and all those needs that weigh in our hearts. We make them known in confidence through your Son, Jesus, the risen Lord, who lives with and through us now and forever.
Amen.
We prepare the altar again. Thank all of you for your continuing support, especially many of you who've sent in contributions for our upcoming Pentecost concert. The donations help us to help many people in your name. Lord God, we ask that you bless this bread and this wine, fruit of the field and fruit of the vines, that soon becomes the very body and blood of Jesus. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours become acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of the Lord Jesus' name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be transformed by your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but especially during this Easter season. Through Jesus, the children of light rise to eternal life. The halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, filled with Easter joy, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit, they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilton, our Bishop, and all of the women and men who lead and guide the church. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him. O God, almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Let us pray in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever."
Amen.
And may the peace of the risen Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
I invite you to share a sign of the Lord's peace.
Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter into my room. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite you to spiritually ask the risen Lord to open up your heart to be able to share the love with others that he shares with us. This is the body of Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of the saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I invite you to pray with me our family prayer for justice and human dignity, crafted by the Archdiocese of Washington. Loving and faithful God, we come to you, Father, to ask through your Son Jesus, and communion with the Holy Spirit, you help us in the battle against America's original sin of racism that divides us from being the body of Christ that we are called to be as your children. We implore you to give us your wisdom so that we may build a community founded on the gospel message of the life and the dignity of all people from the womb to the tomb and live in communion like in the divine communion of the Holy Trinity. Bless as parents that they may form their children in faith, to love one another, regardless of skin color, ethnicity, and national origin, just as Jesus loved us. Bless and protect all of us as we live our faith and be the instruments of your peace, as St. Francis said. Fill us with the thirst of justice and righteousness.
Hear our prayer, give us the courage, compassion, and perseverance to root out any form of injustice within our communities and to bring the healing of Christ to all in need. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Church, hasten to help us and intercede in our behalf so that our diocese can continue to witness the gospel message of the life and dignity of all people.
Amen.
Our announcements. This is the weekend to sign up for SHARE. The SHARE food specials are the crab boil and produce box and baby back ribs. All things you keep around for Memorial Day. First Communion is this coming Sunday at 12 noon. We'll also live stream that, so if you want to come and pray with us at the 12 noon Mass online, we'll have the link with this that was sent out on Saturday night. So 12 noon this Sunday, we'll have First Communion live streamed. And we're doing a May procession this coming Sunday, May 5th, at the 9 o'clock Mass, and again at 12 o'clock. So we'll have a lot of flowers to bring up to Mary. On Mother's Day, next weekend, May 12th, we'll also have flowers for all the mothers and grandmothers and play mothers and expectant mothers and all those kind of good folk. And we'll do a special blessing for all the mothers too. And then Pentecost, the next weekend, May 19th, we'll have our Pentecost concert at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. And you don't need a ticket to come to it. Lots of people like yourself have paid for tickets and said, please give this ticket to someone else. So if anybody you know who wants to come, just tell them to come on. It features all of our music ministries, including the children of our Sunday school. Our exercise class continues on now free of charge at 6 o'clock on Thursdays until, I think, the second weekend. Thursdays at 6 o'clock. It continues until, I think, it's the second Thursday in July. And the only birthday I know about is Jennifer Fairfax. But I'm sure I'll be told others as usual. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord continue to open our eyes and our heart to all the ways that God loves us and ways that we are invited to love others. Let the church say,
amen.
May the Lord give a blessing in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.